Here we have the winols demonstration screen as it opens. This is a winols demo version. You can download this from evc.de and it's free to use in this condition. It does not have all functions. At the moment, having first opened it, you can see that much of it is greyed out. That's not because the functions don't work, it's simply because we haven't got a project open. So what I'll do is I'll open a project. Now, when you use this for the first time, the open button is obviously not going to open anything because you haven't got anything to go and search for opening. This is recent documents, and again, these recent files you haven't got if you're just a starter. So if we go to new, it will give us a choice of where we can get our new file from. Now we can search for a file. If we've left it on the desktop, it might be on the desktop. There's one here in my documents and it's near the top of the list, so it's been picked up there. So if I click that one, that will open that one. Now I'm getting what you could call a warning pop-up here. I'm being told that this is a file I've used before and so I should cancel the import and just open the one I've used before. But of course, if I do that, it will have changes that I've already made, so that would be no good to demonstrate a file. So I'm going to ignore and click OK. Right, now I'm being told that there are no checksums available. Now the reason for that is that this is the Winols demonstration version. If this was Winols paid for version, and had I paid for the checksums for this file, then I would now get an option. In other words, there would be things for me to do. The checksums might be okay, they might need updating. But as this is just a demonstration file, there's nothing I can do but click OK. Right, now I get a project properties box. Now the project properties box can be opened any time by clicking on project and searching down the drop down menu. Over here there's a lot of information that I could put in. Now if you're a beginner, you're probably not going to worry too much about names of files and custom numbers and license plates and so on, but you might want to. I mean, so you can fill that in if you want. These boxes are often blank, but sometimes there's enough information in the file for Winols to grab and put on here, and it has. It's decided it's a passenger car, a VW and a Passat. I could add in it's a B5 if I want. I could say what model is it. It's a 1.9 TD PDI, so I can choose that from the list. If I go over and click on displacement, that information will be auto-entered. So there we go, turbo diesel 1.9. I can put in there that it's a 130 because I know it's a 130. Now up here there's one thing that's quite handy to put in, and that's what build it is. Now I'm not sure exactly which build this one is, but it's an EDC 15, so what I'll do is I'll put EDC 15 in, at least to remind me that that's what this one was. Lots of other bits and pieces that you could add or change, but there is no point in doing these things when you're a beginner because you may never need to use them. So what we'll do is we'll save it. Now we've got our file now, and if we look up here, most of these things now look as if they're going to become active. They're not greyed out, they look active, and we've got a file. Now the file is not in regular numbers at the moment because what it's actually in is in 16-bit view, that's 16-bit view, and it's in hexadecimal, which is FF. If I press the 255 button, I now got a decimal view. So there we are, we've got a decimal view. So I've got 16-bit decimal view, or I've got 16-bit hexadecimal view, which I won't change back to. Now another view that's quite handy is the 8-bit view. Now there's the 8-bit decimal view, and if I want, I can have the 8-bit hexadecimal view. Now what view you choose to use for these files is entirely up to you. You will get used to a view that suits you, and that's the one that you can operate in. I would recommend as a beginner that you started in 16-bit decimal because the numbers do seem to make more sense. Right, there we go, then we've got numbers. We've got a label for our Passat dump. Look, there we are, VW Passat original. Says underneath that this is a hex dump. There we are, hex dump. It starts at 0000. We've got my maps, but of course we haven't got any because we haven't found any yet. Potential maps 84. Ignore what it says there. potential maps 84 does not mean that there are 84 maps. It doesn't even mean there are potentially 84 maps. It means Winols thinks there are 84 maps. That could be 84 maps, it could be 84 bits of maps, it could be anything. So do not rely on that information. If you do, you will come unstuck and you will not be able to use this as a chip tuning software. So don't rely on that ever. Right, now here we go then. We're going back to this. There's our file. We're not going to find a lot by looking through numbers. Unless you're brilliant at searching numbers, you're not going to spot very much. If I change that to the 2D view, I might spot a pattern in amongst that pattern. It looks a bit like a graph. If I change it to 3D view, the odds are, if I scroll the mouse wheel, I'm never going to spot anything in amongst that. I'm never going to recognize anything. You may be able to, but I'm not going to be able to. So I'm going to go back to the 2D view. There we are. There's the 2D view. Now I'm going to quickly run through these controls down here at the bottom and what you can do with different controls. Here it's not really a control, but look, we can do the usual Windows stuff. Make it bigger that way. We can make it bigger this way. So we can make it bigger and smaller. We can minimize. We can maximize, and we can go back to the box that we had open before, that window there. I tend to prefer looking at it like that, but again, it's just personal preference. What you do is entirely up to you. Then we've got some controls. We've got three little buttons here, we've got three little buttons there, and we've got, there's the cursor there. I can move that by clicking and hold and drag. So there we go. I can click to the right and it will jump one screen's worth at a time to the right, or I can click there and it will jump one to the left. I can click here and it will jump one tiny position to the left, or I can click and hold and it will run to the left. This button here, just like its opposite here, will drive you nuts. Try not to hit those by accident, because you can be gaily working here, go to move something, and then you hit that by mistake and it's jumped you straight to the beginning, and now you've got to go and try and find where you were. So that one's the beginning, that one jump you straight to the end. Really helpful in everyday use. Right, I'll put this back up here. This one obviously then will take us one step at a time to the right. This one I can click and hold and go to the right. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this over and position it just in front. I'll get as close as I can. There we are. Just in front of that lump. Now that coloured bit there, that's a piece of data that Winols has identified as being used by the ECU and changeable by you. And there's another block there. Now these two blocks are probably virtually identical. That one may well be for a manual car and that might be for an automatic. If there was a third block, it might be for all-wheel drive or four-wheel drive. Some files will have two blocks, some will have three, some will only have one. If you've only got one, it's great because you've only got one block of data to worry about. If you've got two and you're making changes in one block of data, you might be changing the wrong block. If you're not sure which block is the one your car is using at the moment, the best thing to do is change the data in both. Now Winols does have a little trick for doing that called parallel maps, which I'll come to later, and you can make changes and then say you want to change any parallel maps that are found, and they will be the ones that are over here. So we do have that option. Okay, right, now let's have a look for a map. Having got this far, let's see if we can actually find a map. So what I'll do is, having got as close as that to that block, I'll run this across using that button. Now we could go searching for a map and completely ignore any help from Winols, but Winols has identified this block here as being a map. So what we could do is we could go on the internet and search for that image to find out what it is. We won't find anything, or we're unlikely to find anything, thanks to this up here. Now, you won't know when you open a file which setting this should be on. But a clue is, oh, I don't understand what I'm looking at. And the fact that you don't understand what you're looking at suggests that maybe the organisation being used over here is not the one you want. Now, at the moment it's on high-low, so if I click it, it will change to low high. And if I go over here, this suddenly looks like a map that I can find on the internet. On virtually every chip tuning forum I ever visit, I will find that map. And the reason I will find that map is because most people call it the EGR map, and most cars have got an EGR map. So, you know, a diesel engine with an EGR map, we certainly expect to see that. Right, now, what else do we get from this bit of information? Well, we get a shape, obviously, there's the shape. We get an identity, we're being told it's a 13 by 16, 16-bit map. 16 isn't that 16. What that 16 means is that Winols is telling us it's a Bosch map that's arranged in 16-bit. So you would be best viewing it in 16-bit. Now that may be right, that may be wrong. Winols is quite good at that though, so that is probably correct. 13 by 16 is the axis, so in other words it's got an axis that's 13 units long and an axis that's 16 units long, so that's what it is. And this is going to be our first My Map. And the easy way to do that is to double click on the header. So if I double click there, you see it went red round the outline and now it's grey. The grey highlighting has been put in by Winols. You can put that in yourself when you're searching for maps, but Winols has put that in for us. And over here, what it's done is put the map into My Maps, and it's given me an address for that map. It's saying that that map is there, 4C116, so that's where you find that map. And here is the map. If I bring that just down a little bit, and perhaps over there a little bit, I'll move that one over a little bit more. See, it tries to hide behind it. If I change that to 2D view, you'll see that the 2D view looks like the 2D view that we had before. Now, if you remember before, I said that if you change this to 3D view, you won't recognise much, and you won't. If we change this one to 3D view, hopefully you will recognise that it's an EGR map, because if you go on chip tuning files, you will find that shape in images with people saying, here's my EG map or EGR map, or what is this map? So you will rapidly learn to understand the shape of that one in 3D. So searching for it in 3D might not be easy, but having found it, it is quite recognisable in 3D. Right, let's go back to text, because it's the text that we most likely want to change. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop at this point to make the video a manageable length, and then I'm going to put the next video up explaining what to do with this map and how to save it in a more sensible format for future reference. So I'm just going to stop here.